So in other words, when you solve this thing, yeah, some of you notice right away that you can't have a square root that equals a negative. But we can do this if we check as well, right? If we square both sides. Then we get 5x equals negative 5 times negative 5 is a 25. So when we divide both sides by 5, then we get x is 5. But when we put it back into the expression, we got 5 times 5. And does this equal negative 5? Well, that's the square root of 25, which is just 5. And last time I checked, it doesn't equal negative 5. So we have to be careful on that. This one, since x equals 5 is the only solution we found, then there would be no solutions for this.